Okay, we've finally gotten to my favorite testing topic, which is random testing. And random testing just means that test cases are created, at least in part, using input from a random number generator. This became my favorite testing method a few years ago when I noticed that without even realizing it, I'd written a random tester for every piece of software I ever wrote where I actually cared about its correctness. So I've written at least a dozen random testers. So let's look at how this works. We have a random test case generator. The test case generator takes as input pseudo-random numbers. So PRNG here stands for pseudo-random number generator. Of course, on computers, we almost never get real random number generators. What we rather get are pseudo-random numbers, which are algorithmically generated. But for purposes of creating test cases, they're good enough. The nice thing about pseudo-random numbers is they're repeatable. So when we start using a pseudo-random number generator, we give it a seed which completely determines the sequence of random numbers it's going to generate. So if we ever want to generate the same random numbers, all we have to do is remember the seed. And this is actually really nice because we don't have to save off lots of voluminous random tests. We can rather just remember what seed we started with if we ever want to get back a particular set of random tests. The other thing that goes into a random test case generator, usually to make a good one, you need a significant amount of domain knowledge. By domain knowledge, I just mean that you have to understand some properties of the software under test. And we'll talk in quite a bit of detail about what form this domain knowledge might take and how you encode this as part of the random test case generator. So generated test cases come out of the random test case generator, and they go into the software under test. The software under test executes, produces some output. The output is inspected by a test oracle. And the oracle, as we've already learned, makes a determination whether the output of the software under test was either good or bad. If the output is good, that is to say, if it passes whatever checks we have, we just go back and do it again. On the other hand, if the output's not okay, we save the test case somewhere for later inspection, and we go back and do more random testing. And so the key to making this all work is we wrap the entire random testing tool chain in some sort of a driver script, which runs it automatically. What we do is we start the random tester on some otherwise unused machine, and we go and do other things, or we go home. And while we're doing other things, the random testing loop executes hundreds or thousands or millions of times. The next time we feel like seeing what's going on, maybe we come to work in the morning, and we basically just see what kind of test cases have been saved. If anything interesting turned up, we have some follow-up work to do, like creating a reportable test case and debugging. If nothing interesting happened, then that's good. We didn't introduce any new bugs, and we can rebuild the latest version of the software under test and start the testing loop again. Generally, the way random testing works is it's not necessarily part of the test suite for the software under test, but rather it's a separate testing loop that gets run independently, acts as a separate or an external quality assurance mechanism. If the random test case generator is well done, and if we give a sufficient amount of CPU resources to the testing loop, and if it's not finding any problems, random testing can significantly increase our confidence that the software under test is working as intended. And it turns out that, in general, there are only a couple of things that are hard about making this work. First of all, it can be tricky to come up with a good random test case generator. And second, it can be tricky to come up with good oracles. And of course, we've already said that these are the hard things about testing in general, making test cases and determining if outputs are correct. Basically, the same thing's the case here. But the character of the problems that we run into while doing random testing are a little bit different. And that's what we're going to spend the next several units of this course looking at. What I'd like to do now is go over a couple of real examples. One of them involves a very large random tester testing quite complicated pieces of software. The other one is almost trivial. It's a tiny, almost one-line random tester that's testing a small function that I wrote. So let's take a look at those.